welcome to choral Evensong at St Mary's. The intro this evening was O Most Merciful by Charles Wood. To those of you who don't know me, I'm Helga and I'm in my first year of ministry training at St Augustine's College of Theology. If any of you would like to help me with that endeavour, I do have some feedback forms, so volunteers welcome. From the rising of the sun to its setting, my name is great among the nations, saith the Lord of hosts. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. Dearly beloved, the scripture moveth us in sundry places to acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, and that we should not dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but confess them with an humble, lowly, penitent, and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the same by his infinite goodness and mercy. And although we ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before God, yet ought we most chiefly so to do when we assemble and meet together, to render thanks for the great benefits that we have received at his hands, to set forth his most worthy praise, to hear his most holy word, and to ask those things which are requisite and necessary, as well as for the body as for the soul. Wherefore, I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace, saying with me, Almighty and most merciful Father,
we have learned to stray from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and there is no wealth in us. And now, O Lord, have mercy upon us in this world of offenders. Spare now them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore now them
first reading is taken from the book of Isaiah. Behold, my servant shall deal prudently. He shall be exalted and extolled and be very high. Just as many were astonished at you, so his visage was marred more than any man, and his form more than the sons of men. So shall he sprinkle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths at him. For what had not been told them, they shall see. And what they had not heard, they shall consider. Who has believed our report? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of dry ground. He has no form or comeliness, and when we see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we did not esteem him. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment, and who will declare his generation? For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgressions of my people he was stricken, and they made his grave with the wicked, but with the rich at his death, because he had done no violence, nor was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. He has put him to grief. When you make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed, he shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. He shall see the labor of his soul and be satisfied. By his knowledge, my righteous servant shall justify many, for he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore I will divide him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he poured out his soul unto death. And he was numbered with the transgressors, and he bore the sin of many, and made intercessions for the transgression, for the transgressors. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
The second reading is taken from the book of Luke. Now behold, two of them were travelling that same day to a village called Emmaus, which was 7 miles from Jerusalem. And they talked together of all these things which had happened. So it was, while they conversed and reasoned, that Jesus himself drew near and went with them. But their eyes were restrained, so they did not know him. And he said to them, "What kind of conversation is this that you have with one another as you walk and are sad?" Then one of those, whose name was Cleophas, answered and said to him, "Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem, and have not you known the things which happened there in these days?" And he said to them, "What things?" So they said to him, "The things concerning Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how the chief priests and our rulers delivered him to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we were hoping that it was he who was going to redeem Israel. Indeed, besides all this, today is the third day since these things happened. Yes, and certain women of our company who arrived at the tomb early astonished us when they did not find his body. When they did not find his body, they came saying that they had also seen a vision of angels who said he was alive. And certain of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it, just as the women had said, but him they did not see." Then he said to them, "O foolish ones, and slow of heart to believe in all that the prophets have spoken. Ought not the Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory?" And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded to them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. Then they drew near to the village where they were going, and he indicated that he would have gone farther. But they constrained him, saying, "Abide with us, for it is toward evening, and the day is far spent." And he went in to stay with them. Now it came to pass, as he sat at the table with them, that he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they knew him, and he vanished from their sight. And they said to one another, "Did not our heart burn within us while he talked with us on the road, and while he opened the scripture to us?" So they rose up that very hour and returned to Jerusalem, and found the 11 and those who were there with them gathered together, saying, "The Lord is risen indeed and has appeared to Simon." And they told about the things that had happened on the road and how he was known to them in the breaking of bread. Here ends the second lesson.
Thank you.
William Harris. Those born to new life in the waters of baptism may know the power of his resurrection. Lord, in thy mercy.
Hear our prayer.
That those who suffer pain and anguish may find healing and peace in the wounds of Christ. Lord, in thy mercy.
Hear our prayer.
That in the undying love of Christ, we may be united with all who have died in the faith of Christ. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us commend the world in which Christ rose from the dead to the mercy and protection of God. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Risen Christ, for whom no door is locked, no entrance barred. Open the doors of our hearts, that we may seek the good of others and walk the joyful road of sacrifice and peace, to the praise of God the Father. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We stand to sing our final hymn, number 103.
Thank you.